right, so today we're bringing you the kind of continuing our dark series, or you know, it's summertime. Great time to get out on the lakes when it's a little cooler at the night, especially under a good moonlit night. The Blue Bruiser, Zombie Blue Bruiser, one of my favorites. Like any crankbait fishing, do not discount it at night. And this is one heck of a color pattern. So we've got our fresh cut stencils on our magwort here, and we're gonna lay down a white base coat. Do a couple of these on camera for you, and so we don't have too lengthy of a video, and we'll move on to the next color like we most generally do. There's a step or a process that I go a little faster and you'd like to see a little more in depth, just leave a comment below. Now, summer is a tremendous time to night fish. A lot of people are just very disinterested in that, but I'm telling you, it is it's a lot of fun. Kind of get out there in the evenings, everybody's working hard all during the week, and gives you an opportunity. You don't have to stay out real late, you know, it gets dark 9-10 o'clock, stay till midnight, especially on a moonlit night. It's the first time you've ever night fished. You know, I would definitely recommend going on a full moon night. You'd be surprised at how it lit up those lakes and those contours. Once your eyes get adjusted to it, be surprised at how well you can actually see out there. You know, I do run black lights on my boat, and been night fishing for many, many, many years. Actually in a bass club here in Oklahoma that we traditionally just night fish, and my boys out there, I hope you're watching some of the videos, and some of them have fished with me and using this exact pattern had tremendous nights on catching fish. One of the best fish catches nights I've ever had was actually using this pattern. A good friend of mine was, we were fishing on a kind of on a secondary point, not having just a lot of success, and he picked up some custom painted Blue Bruisers that I had done up for him, and I believe he was using a wiggle wart, and I mean, he went to catching some good size smallmouth. And you know, to be a little bit different, I switched to a rock crawler in that same pattern, and we actually caught fish. We left fish biting. Well, that one there, I didn't do a very good job of cutting that one.
Good night.
Let's redo this a little bit. Sorry about that. I got this a little bit long. Getting back to the story, we left fish biting that next morning, and I mean, we had fished probably 12 to 14 hours, and I'm going to say 10 of those hours were using the Blue Bruiser, and we come in first that night in our little jackpot and caught almost every single fish we had on crankbaits all night. Now, most generally, it doesn't always work like that. It's fishing, but that was an incredible night. One of the best that I can remember, in which the fish just stayed on that particular crankbait and that color scheme the entire night. Incredible night. Had a lot of fun. A rock crawler actually ended up, I think, coursing, I think, I may have been in the front of the boat on that one, but the rock crawler ended up catching a few bigger fish than the wiggle wart did that night, but wow, what a night. So, I highly recommend night fishing in the summer. We actually, in our bass club, start sometimes even in late February when it's cold. What I'm doing, I'm turning that because I've got these really down low on this particular bait. And so just kind of rotate that way, you get a little bit cleaner edge if you're spraying into something. If you're not, and you can kind of see I've got a little bit of gap right there and a little bit of gap right there. I need to adjust on this one after that paint dries a little bit. So I'm gonna do a couple coats on this. I was yakking quite a bit, so we ended up seeing most of the base coating process of these baits. So I will speed it up when we switch colors and not make you watch all six of these. Again, these are going out to a guy in Texas that is a night fisherman. We've been doing his custom order. If you watched back a few weeks ago, we showed you kind of an unboxing of his custom order and how to send in custom orders, if I've posted that video yet. And so this is a color I haven't posted online yet, one I've been doing for a long, long time. And again, most of these colors I've kind of kept tight-lipped a little bit as far as locally here, but you know, what the heck. People see some of these colors I do, especially in this nighttime series, and they're just not that interested in nighttime fishing, especially with crankbaits. But I'm just telling you, it can happen. Don't discount it. Give it a try. Stick with it a few hours. Try some different banks. If you know there's fish that's active there, throw some crankbaits at night. Be a very, very productive pattern. All right. So we have our white base coat on. I'm gonna step back, clean the brush out here a little bit, or add some colors to my second, third airbrush. Make sure always check your edges, especially at this process, for making sure you're good and secure. And we are just gonna go in and lay some pearl blue down. Got a little bit of cleaner left in that, so make mistakes like that, just get you a paper towel, dab that a little bit. It's not gonna be that big a deal because we're gonna cover it. Should have sprayed the paint out a little bit. But maybe this will be a little better image, so. Just worried about the lower half, but I generally just throw a little of that over it to help with coverage. As you can see, I'm tilting that so I don't get any kind of underspray under it, under my Frisket stencil. Just a nice little light coat. Yeah, I've done four there. We'll move on to the next stage. Okay, so we're gonna kind of add a little bit of quite a bit of a darker blue, midnight blue, to the back color. And we wanna just fade that down into our lighter pearl blue and leave that bottom edge of those craw real light pearl. Just a little bit of a transition there and nice little fade. So again, I just started the nose, worked to the tail. Get a good dark edge up at the top, then work our fade in, let that paint just flow down a little bit into that lighter blue. We want that top half pretty dark, so I'm just, I don't know if you can tell, I'm just kind of angling my brush, so I'll get a little bit of that fade as I work to the bottom of the bait. One more time. Okay, for this next thing, we're gonna do a little stippling, splatter. Again, just gonna remove my nozzle cap, is what I call it. May not be the correct term, but we've got our red loaded up in here. We're also going to reduce our pressure to about 10 working pounds, and we're gonna throw down some red splatter. And it's important to do this before you take your Frisket off, because when we remove this Frisket, you're going to see that we have a clear bodied lure. And just put as much as you want on with this red. When we come back and outline our crawl pattern, we're going to do that in black, so some of it may get hidden just a little bit, but again, all I'm doing is, I hope we can see this in camera, is just working it. I've got the droplet sizes like I want them, and every paint, time of year you're painting is a little bit different, so. We're at 10, getting the droplet size. For example, I can go to 5, and we're not getting much of anything. Went too low. Go to 15, and you can tell we've got much smaller, more atomized paint. And if that's what you like, go with it. I prefer a little bit bigger droplets on this pattern, so we'll come back down to 8 to 10 working pounds. And we'll just go ahead and show this on every bait. Just random splatters. Got a little bit of some drying stuff going on here. We'll fix that when we heat set it. Probably was the very last. Again, I mixed all these paints with 411 reducer to get it to the right consistency. That sometimes maybe I didn't get that mixed very well right there, and was the last bait and the last of the paint. And so we're going to bring our pressure back up to about 22, shooting about 21 psi, and now we're going to come back with our black. Again, it's a crawl pattern, and so I like the black eyes. So We're just going to do that freehand, darken up those eyes by making small circles, start in the center, and just work your way out. Mainly spraying on the Frisket here. And on fresh, like I was saying, on fresh Frisket, it's kind of hard to see all those details in the pattern, but after you used it once, and that's how we do our outline. And again, you don't want that super thin. You're going to get a good crisp line because you got that Frisket on there. And then again, you can extend this up into the back if you'd prefer. I'm gonna run a stripe of black right down the back. Okay, we'll move on to the next color. Okay, so we're gonna remove the Frisket here. I'm just gonna show you this on one lure. You wanna be, just take your time, go real slow. Try to get an even lift. We have not heat set any of this paint. And if you didn't do lure prep very well by making sure you got all the oils, everything removed, you can sometimes lift some edges of that paint. So once you do that, you want to make sure you get a good heat set. Again, I'm using the heat gun. You can use a hair dryer. In fact, I prefer, if you're a beginner, to start off and haven't used the heat gun, to use a hair dryer. These get extremely hot. You got to be very conscientious about how close you're holding the gun to the bait. And we'll get a nice little heat set, and we're gonna add our belly color. But I'm gonna go back, take the Frisket off the rest of this, and we'll come back and shoot the last color of the night. All right, for the last step, or I should say, shouldn't say last step, we still gotta clear coat it. And I'll probably go ahead and show that process to you again. I've showed it in many videos, and in fact, up at the top, I'll put a link to the spraying Tamco playlist. May have it in the description below, but we have a light blue that we're going to come in and throw on this belly. And this is a coat that's going to have to be built up and heat set in between. Because this is a very light, I'll go ahead and show you what I'm using here, transparent Caribbean blue. You just don't want to go too heavy at once. Two or three heat sets and sprays, and you'll get it to the color that you want. And I'll bring that up into those sides just a little bit more as I get that belly color built up. But this is a, and it may be because I've got an older bottle of this, but it just takes several coats on this clear belly in order to get that Caribbean blue to the shade that I prefer. Like I said, you can add a little up into that. Of course, don't be trying to do detail work at that kind of pressure, but. And before clear coat, that is what you're looking for in the blue Bruiser. Give you a good close up. Hope that's picking up on the camera. Superior nighttime crankbait. This big wiggle wart, it ought to be the ticket to. Like I said, I've fished them on just about every single pattern I use, as far as a, I say pattern, different style of crankbait that I use, and had a lot of success on wiggle wards and rock crawlers, which are very similar wide wobbling crankbaits nighttime around the full moon. So give this a try, guys. I'm gonna tell you, if you'll get out there, low light situations, even in the evening, if you're just gonna shut down, throw the blue bruiser, give me some feedback on how you do on it. Super nighttime pattern. We'll come back, do a clear coat, show you the colors that we put into this, and we'll wrap this video up. Final step, we're gonna go ahead and show you the Tamco spray session. Got 3/4 of a teaspoon of our clear and 1/4 teaspoon of our 7605 hardener, medium cure, and we're gonna throw some music on and we're just gonna go spraying some clear. Got to get the exhaust fans on for this one. That's the Blue Bruiser. Guys, if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. Comment below. Tell me what you think of this zombie Blue Bruiser. And we got a little fly trying to stick to our clear. That's why I'm in a garage shop spraying. As soon as I get done with this, we're going inside, let this stuff cure in the air-conditioned temperatures of the home. But anyway, appreciate everybody that's viewing the channel. Until next week, Green Country Baits signing out.